Welcome to Tranquilly Coding. Today I have some news to share with you. Up until now, all of our videos was about coding with no voices, only the sweet sound of keyboards and the background musics. But from now on, I will try to add my voices to the videos so I can explain you better all of the things that we will go through. Today I'll be starting a new series on appwrite. So why this video series? For a couple of weeks, I have been using and testing the appwrite for Android, and I think I have something to share with you. Basically, the main objective for this video was to show you how to use appwrite for Android using Kotlin. There are several videos about appwrite in the YouTube and other platforms, but for Android, there isn't much. Except for their documentation on appwrite, we don't have much of the things for Android as a tutorial or as a whole playlist tutorial for Android in any of the platform that we use regularly. So for the last couple of weeks, the experience I have gained from appwrite in Android platform, I want to share with you, and I want to make it easy for you so that you don't need to go through every single documentation and look for every single problem that you will face. I want you to have like the easier experience that we get from a structured tutorial on a certain topic. So this will be a video series about appwrite for Android using Kotlin. This is the first video to give you a little introduction about what is appwrite and how everything works with appwrite. So appwrite is an open source platform that has a lot of features to offer. Previously, it was completely self-hosted platform, so you can install it, host it anywhere you want, like from Docker or your host or any places that is possible. Actually, I don't have that much experience with the backend, so backend as a service like appwrite or Firebase was the option for me to go. So appwrite previously was self-hosted. Right now they have a cloud platform that will allow you to use the appwrite directly from their website, their cloud platform, so you don't need to install it anywhere at all. So appwrite has different options like authentication. They have their own authentication method, and they support like nearly every authentication provider that is available. They have a database which is based on MariaDB, but it is like easier NoSQL database, and mostly their SDK covers everything that we need. They have a storage bucket. They have cloud functions in their free tier which wasn't available in the Firebase. They have real-time database and much more. So let's check the SDKs that are available for appwrite. So for the client-side app, for example, a website or a Flutter app, or maybe an Android or Apple app. So they have SDK for all of these things. This is the SDK for Android. They have all the features available that you need created and built in this SDK. And there is server-side SDK that will allow you to control, create an admin panel and everything without going to the appwrite console at all. So most of the things you can control from there, like you can create a dashboard in Android as well. Like there is SDK for Kotlin, and this will be used as a server-side app. You can create any server-side admin functions or any kind of methods or APIs you can use from an Android app, and that will act as an admin panel or something like that. This is the SDK for Kotlin. The most amazing things about appwrite is their documentation. So anything you want to go, there is a proper documentation of every single step. For example, if you want to go for Android, let's go to Android. So there is how to create a project on Android, how to implement it and everything else. So we will be going through each of them in the further videos. Right now I'm just here to give you a quick tour. For example, the authentication, if you go to, for example, accounts, so you will find how to create a sign up, login preference, this kind of stuff. And in here always you have the option to choose your language and platform that you're using. So the most amazing part is the API references. So for example, you want to learn about the database. If you go to the database, you will see separate sections. So this is the client SDK and the platform is web, so you can see how to do all of these things. In the right side, you will see the quick links for all the options that is available. Let's choose the Android for Kotlin. So we have the list document for Android Kotlin, and this is the whole code. You can just directly copy and paste this code, it will work. This is the get document. And if you want to create an like admin panel app or a server side app, so that will be your server side SDK and it will be Kotlin if you want to make an Android server side app. And that will have the every single option you can think of actually. So like you can create databases, list databases. So what is create database? You can create database from your admin app without going to the console at all. You can create a collection or list collection, every single thing over here. So the documentation is well documented. So for example, if we see the get database method call, so this is the code. If we use this, we'll get the database. And best thing is they always give you the response. So there will be a response, it will be a JSON file. Let's open it and see how it looks. So we'll get an ID, a name, a created date, updated date, and if it is enabled or not. This is the JSON file. So you can format this JSON data without even creating a call to the server to get what is the output of it. You can already write the code based on this JSON data because it will always be like this no matter the platform you are using. AppWrite has a pretty good free plan, and that pro plan is the one of the reason I have chosen AppWrite to be my backend as a service whenever I need the backends. So for the free package, we have unlimited projects, we have 10 gigabyte of bandwidth, 2 GB storage, 750,000 execution of cloud functions, 75k monthly active users. This is pretty good for any single project you want to start. It would be good enough to handle lots of users, and this is a pretty decent free tier. Compared to Firebase, if we see that, they have like a similar plan, like you have 1 gigabyte database storage, you have 10 gigabyte downloads, that is the bandwidth here. But the good thing is, in the pro plan, it is $15 per member per month. So if you are using only single person this, it will be only $15, but you have 300 gigabyte of bandwidth, 150 gigabyte of storage, and 3.5 million execution of cloud functions. So if you try to scale up your project, or you are going to have much more user or requirement for these bandwidths and limits, it is just $15 for all of this. And you can have additional bandwidth like $40 for 100 gigabyte of bandwidth, or $3 per 100 gigabyte of storage. So this is pretty good pricing compared to the pricing of Firebase. If you try to use the calculator, pricing calculator, you will see like hundreds and hundreds of dollars of bill from this pay-as-you-go Blaze plan. So the Spark plan, it will be good enough for creating the project, but when you are starting to scale, this will completely suck. And then the best thing of this AppWrite, that is, it is completely open source. So AppWrite is an open source project. If you go to their GitHub account, they have 102 repositories. This is about every single SDK languages or stuff they are making. And all of the people contributing here making it best for all of the use cases. It is a common saying that open sources are always better. So you have the whole source code of everything. You can check yourself. You can contribute it there. The AppWrite main repository is this. And there is 323 contributors on GitHub working on this. They have an amazing community Discord. You can join it from this link below. And you have it is available on the website as well. So if you go to the community tab, you can click on the join on Discord and you will be invited to the Discord channel. You have a support option there where people ask different set of questions to get help on the separate different problem they will encounter in any of the SDKs available. And this is pretty helpful. I have tried it. So this is actually the introduction for this tutorial course. There will be several other videos which will include how to set up the projects, how to create the account, these basics toward the advanced level of authentication, OAuth authentication, database and storage stuff, much more. So I don't know how far I can go with this series, or I don't know if I can be able to go with the cloud function and stuff, but for the uses that we regularly do on Firebase, I will try to cover every aspect on this particular part, so that in appwrite you can build the app as easy as you did on Firebase. So this is for today. I'll see you in the next video.